Okay, so on this one, you're saying you believe that the Christian worldview gives a better foundation for science.
Right.
I'll let you lay that case out real briefly.
Yeah, and this isn't to say that you have to be a Christian to practice science, or that other worldviews didn't, there weren't people in other worldviews that had some scientific progress was made. But I think it's a fairly rigor, or you can make a fairly strong case that the scientific enterprise was birthed in a Judeo-Christian worldview, because in order for to do science, there's a, you know, different philosophical requirements that you got to have laws of nature uniform throughout the universe, that the universe is distinct and objective reality that can be studied, that it's regular and orderly, that that the universe is intelligible, that it's not divine, so it's not to be worshipped. You know, it's good to study that humans have the ability to discover the universe's intelligibility, that that the intellectual virtues essential to science of testing and falsifiability and integrity, that those are, that all of these things, to do science you have to act as though these things are true, and the worldview that anchors all of those and says that they all ought to be true is the Christian worldview.
Well, I mean, to me, this, I don't know, I don't understand how you can say that, because for me, the reason why I like science is because I believe that it has proven itself. In other words, a good theory can make predictions, and the predictions come true, and that just shows the power. If somebody doesn't use science and they use something else, like, let's say, for example, you go to war and somebody uses science, they can create a better weapon than somebody who wants to cast spells, for example. Person casting spells is going to lose that real quick. So
right.
The thing I like about science is that it proves itself. Proof is in the pudding kind of thing. So you said that the Christian worldview expects nature to be uniform, regular, orderly, but that seems to contradict everything, because, for example, you don't believe in biological evolution, that humans evolved from other animals. You believe that humans were just created, boom, from scratch, and also certain animals, like whales, boom, giraffes, boom, tigers, boom. So that would just blow apart all deductive, inductive logic, abductive. I mean, when you try to explain how that came, it's basically, whenever you say a miracle, that means you totally threw out the window. You threw out uniformity, you threw out regularity, you threw out your orderliness. You threw all that stuff out the window.
Well, I would disagree, and again, I want to iterate here. I agree very much that science has a great capacity, and it's demonstrated its effectiveness. But again, when I'm looking at what worldview anchors all of the things that make science so successful, that it's the Christian worldview that argues that the world is worthy of study, that it's not divine, that we should be worshipped, because if it should be worshipped, you don't study it. That it's intelligible because it flows out of how reliably God sustains creation. It's orderly and reliable and intelligible because of that. That humanity has the capacity to understand it because we're made in God's image and can see what he's done and understand that. And so I'm not saying that I agree that science is incredibly successful, but when you look throughout history, it seems like the worldview that allowed science to blossom and flourish is arguably the Christian, or, you know, the Judeo-Christian Western society where that happened.
But if you're going to believe that God made humans from scratch, don't you agree that you have to throw out the uniformity, the regularity, and the orderliness of all of nature, because you're saying nature could not have done that through regular processes? It took a miracle. There's no way to figure out scientifically how it happened, because it never happened.
Well, I two things I would say. One is that God doing something doesn't mean that it operates outside the laws of physics. And again, I would argue that as I understand Christian theology, that creation, if God were to withdraw his hand, creation would just simply cease to exist. And so the fact that it operates so reliably is a reflection of how consistently and reliably God sustains creation. And so that's what provides the foundation of why we can go look and see oh, this thing that happened today, given the same circumstance, is going to happen identically tomorrow.
But when it comes to the creation of humans, you're saying that nature is not uniform. It's not regular. It's not orderly. It's very disjunctive to have a miracle. That means it cannot happen naturally, you're saying.
I agree that there are times where God steps in and does things that cannot be explained via the laws of physics. But that doesn't mean that we have to throw science out the window, and particularly if science, or if looking at creation was all we had to do, that I agree that would be very difficult.
Well, let me put it this way: can you figure out how humans came to be through science?
Aspects, yeah. I don't think completely, because I don't think consciousness and what I would consider being made in God's image is something that's going to be explainable just simply via the laws of physics.
Well, it seems like if you're going to, you know, if you're going to use uniformity, regularity, and orderliness to try to explain everything, like the origin of humans, then, I mean, if you're looking at that, you just, a miracle is not going to be one of those things, because a miracle is not orderly, regular, or uniform. That's the opposite of a miracle, basically.
No, I would agree. But again, I would say if creation was all we had to look at, that would be a problem. But I also, God's revealed himself through creation that we can study via science, but he's also revealed himself through scriptures. And it's when I look at integrating both of those, I would also recognize, okay, there's something about humanity that's not going to be completely explainable via science, although science can give us a great amount or has great insight into a lot of aspects of humanity. So it's I don't see why, just because there are occasional miracles, and I would argue that we see those as revealed through scripture, why I have to throw out science just because there might be an occasional miracle, especially if I can identify where that miracle would have occurred.
Yeah, but I mean, it's a lot more just an occasional. I mean, you're talking about every single major species or kind or whatever was made from scratch. For example, tigers have no biological connection with giraffes and sharks and humans and pine trees, whereas a naturalist would say these are all related through DNA. You know, even the plants and the animals are all related through DNA.
But I've never said that God just poofed them into existence. I do think God has used both process and direct intervention. So I think at least as I've studied Christianity, Christian theology, the idea that the capacity of animals to adapt to environment, that could have some efficacy of producing new creatures that God might then go and change into something a little different, particularly the relational capacity of animals. And so I don't see those as being contradictory to one another.
Well, I thought you believed that humans kind of basically poofed into existence. So you're saying you think more like God maybe used evolution and it was God guided then? I'm not sure exactly what your view is. Can you be real brief about how you think God made humans?
I think in terms of how the physical bodies are made, I don't have a good answer. I don't think scripture is that definitive as to whether this was just something that, you know, the body was something completely new. But I do think the consciousness, the image of God, that is biblically what distinguishes humanity from all the rest of the animals, that's something that is introduced by God that doesn't have a physical explanation. So I think it's probably a combination of where we can get a physical or maybe some physical mechanism as well as God intervening to bring about human consciousness.
Okay, ready for the next topic?
Sure.